So, why does screen calibration matter? Well, hello, welcome to this Fotospeed video with me, Tim Jones. Today, what we're going to be looking at is screen calibration and mainly focusing on why we need to calibrate our screen, but also how we calibrate our screen as well. So I've got two devices I'm going to run through today, which is the Datacolor Spyder X Pro, which is Datacolor's screen calibration device. And I've also got the Calibrite Color Checker Display as well from Calibrite, which is their version of the screen calibration device. Both equally really good devices, both work fantastically, both have really great software and user-friendly software. But I wanted to do a run through of actually how we use this software, what are the best settings and things. So what I've done, it's a bit of a long video, this one. So now I've put timestamps in so you can jump to your particular screen calibrator. Now, be it if you've got the Datacolor devices or you've got the Calibrite or the older X-Rite devices, the software is pretty much the same for the older devices as well as these latest versions of. So just look down in the description and you'll see I've divided it down into timestamps for you. I've also done a little bit of an evaluation at the end to see which ones I prefer, to be honest, because these two devices, they kind of go up against each other a little bit. So I want to just see which one is best, really, and if there's any difference. Because to be honest, there shouldn't really be any difference because the colour patches they're working from are the same, set out by the International Colour Consortium, etc. And they all create ICC profiles. So it just comes down to software and preference, really. So the screen calibrations should be the same. Now, the screen I'm using is my BenQ behind me here. And I'm just going to calibrate that. But also, I have tried it on my laptop as well, which is a Mac, and it's got that lovely glossy screen. So you can run all this software and things on laptops or standalone screens as well. The reason why I'm just doing it on my BenQ is because it's nice and big and hopefully it will translate into video, because screen calibration can be a little bit tricky to see when we're actually videoing. So you have to take my word for it in some cases of what is actually happening and if there's any differences between the two. But before we get started, as always, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Just click that subscribe button. So let's dive into the software and let's start with the Datacolor Spyder X. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is actually go to the Datacolor website to download the software. Now, it's not quite obvious where the software is, and it took me a little while, to be honest, to actually kind of find the software and where it is. If you click on Contact, and then you've got Spyder software downloads just down in one of the squares here, just in this, just under the FAQ section. So if we click here, then what will happen is it will take us to the new website. And again, not a lot happens. So I'm just going to click it again. And then it comes up for us here. So what we want to do, because I've got the Pro here, I haven't got the Elite with me, I've just got the Pro. And I'm on a Mac, so I'm just going to click on the Spyder X monitor calibration and 5.8 for Mac OS. And that will just start to download now. Just need to click here and then that will download. And then once it's downloaded, I'll get it installed and then we'll go into the software itself. Okay, so I have installed the Spyder Pro software. And we get this little warning message. So we're just going to click OK. And then basically, we've got to make sure our device is plugged into my USB port, which it is. And then I'm just going to click Next. And it will just have a quick search for it and find it. That's my license. That's absolutely fine. We'll just click OK. And then we'll just click through those devices. And it will just start the software now. So basically, what we need to do is basically just work through each of these sections. So it will take us through each of these. So what we need to do is I just want to just go through and tick all those boxes just to say, yes, I've reset everything. It's all absolutely fine. Okay, so I've got a desktop screen here. So I'm just going to select that and click Next. Now I've got a BenQ, it's found it, fantastic. So let's just click there. So I'm gonna want to adjust the brightness. So we're gonna just set that on there as well. My screen has a brightness control. Now, it's an LED, so that's fine. We'll just click next through all these. I'm gonna do a full calibration. Now, you'll notice here at the bottom, I've got a gamut setting, a white point setting, and also a brightness setting. So the gamut is fine at 2.2. White point is gonna be 6,500 Kelvin, which is perfect for photography. That's the setting we want. So at the minute, the brightness is 120, which is absolutely fine. That's kind of a good place to start. We can also just turn off if we didn't want it to adjust for brightness, and then we just wanted to set our own brightnesses and things in here. We wanted to change the white point as well. We could change that in there. So let me just click next. And now what we're gonna do is to place the spider on my desk, which I've done in front of me. So I'm just gonna click next, and it's just gonna measure the ambient room light. Now at the minute it's telling me the brightness of my screen is gonna be 200 candescents. So that is way too high. So what we need to do is just click the box that says keep the settings you selected. So I'm gonna keep that there, and it's gonna just change that for me. Then we'll just click next. So now it's just gonna ask me to put the spider, take it out of its holder, and place it on the screen like so. So then I can just hold it there and make sure that I'm just holding it in place, and then just click next. And now what I do is I've just gotta hold it in this position while it does the measurements for me. So that is what I'm gonna do. Just hold it here, and you see here it's firing all these targets through, so we can just get what. Now, on here, you'll notice it's just stopped now, and we've just got a target on the right-hand side that tells us our screen and things. So at the minute, I'm about 100, which is kind of where I want to be honest. So I'm just going to click OK, and then just click update, and it's actually just gonna measure. And then at the bottom here, I'm just gonna click continue because I'm happy with that setting. If we weren't happy with that, we could adjust our brightness on the screen to match what was coming out. So we could do those adjustments. But I'm quite happy with that setting, about 102, 100, 102. So I'm quite happy with those. So now I can just keep my hand on here. I'm just gonna swap arms because my arm's starting to ache a little bit. So we can just hold it on here, and it will do the rest of the measurements for us. Okay, so once it's finished, it will just tell us it's finished. So we just take the screen calibrator off and put the cover back on, pop it on our desk, and then just click finish down the bottom here. So it's just telling me that my adjusted brightness didn't match that original one, which is absolutely fine. I'm more than happy with that. Now with the screen calibration, I'm just gonna put today's date in there, and we'll just click save. And then it has just done our calibration here. And we can actually then do a before and after, so we can switch between. So we'll just click next, and then we are finished. And it will show us our Adobe RGB range, which is pretty good, to be honest. I'm quite happy with that. And we can flick between different color spaces if we needed to. But we're usually looking at Adobe RGB, and I'm near enough there, to be honest. Okay, so that was how we calibrate the screen with the Spyder. Nice and simple, I hope you agree. Nice step-by-step instructions. We've just got to get that brightness right, and then the rest of it should all fall into place for us. So now let's put the spider down, and I'm gonna run through how to use the Calibrite software and actually the screen calibrator as well. So we're gonna run through that software. So let's dive back into the computer, and I'll show you how that software works. So the first thing we need to do, a bit like exactly the same as the Datacolor and the Spyder X, is actually go to the Calibrite website and download the software. So we need to go to the Calibrite website, click on support and software downloads. So a little bit easier than the Datacolor website. It's a bit more obvious. Now, if we just scroll down, what I'm looking for is CC Profiler, which is a Color Checker Pro, which is the one I've got here. It also does the X-Rite i1 Display Pro as well. So I'm just going to download it for Mac because that's what I'm on here. Just allow the download and we'll get that downloaded and we'll get that installed. So I've installed the software and I've got CC Profiler installed. Looks pretty similar to i1 Profiler, which was the older version. So this is going to be, we're going to do this in the basic function. There is an advanced in here as well, and we can go into profiling and things a little bit more in depth. However, I'm just going to run through on the basic setting and click on where it says display profiling, because that's what we're going to be doing. So now I have the kind of the walkthrough, shall we say. So the luminance, I'm actually going to set this to 100 in here. My white point at the top is going to be D65. So D65 is 6,500 Kelvin. Then also I've got my gamut setting here as well. So all the settings we had in the Spyder software we have in here, it's just in a different kind of place. We've also got a nice color, a color space in front of us here. So really nice there. Okay. Now we click next, which is just the arrow down the bottom here. And we very simply are ready to start our adjustment. So if I just click on start adjustment, it's very similar to the Spyder. It's just going to ask me to just open it up. For best results, make sure your measuring device resting flat on the display like this. And then we're just going to click OK. And then we are going to just click through in the top left here. We'll just click through the next option and then it will just start by measuring some contrast and the white point of the screen for us. And it will just flick through and do a basic kind of adjustment for us. Okay, so the luminance is measured at 105 and we want to get it to 100. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go into my brightness settings on the screen and then we're just going to adjust that brightness there. So nice and down there. Okay. Then I'm just going to click next. And then we can just go through and it's just going to measure all these lovely patches that it's going to do. It's going to do 118 patches. So you may need to swap arms as it's going through. But I'm just going to leave it to run, and then once it's finished, I will come back to you. Okay, so now the screen calibration's finished, I can just take it off, put the cover back on, and then pop it back on my desk next to it. And then I'm just going to click through to the next option. And it's here that we can now have a look and see how the profile looks. So it says we're successful. That's great. Just click on the next button down the bottom here. And it's here I can save the profile. So we've got BenQ ICC and I'm going to call this the display in here. And then I'm just going to click save profile and then it's created the profile for us. And we can do before and afters. So we've got a before and we've got an after. So actually the before, again, was a little bit, had a little bit of kind of green or something in there. And now it's just neutralized all that out for me. We can also change the colors here. So we've got magenta. So it's a little bit kind of intense, the magenta before, but it's just kind of just brought it down a little bit for us. Just to kind of have a better kind of reaction to the print in here, rated. And we're done. That is all we need to do. We just click home and then we're done. Okay, so hopefully that's shown you how the basic operations of the software work and how easy it can be to calibrate your screen. So be it with the Calibrite one we've just done or with the Spyder as well. Both give fantastic results. Both, I have to say, are very comparable as well. When flicking between screen calibrations, it's very hard to show on video. I have tried, don't worry. I did try and film it and things, but it just wasn't going to show. When I was flicking between profiles, you kind of have to trust me on this one, that basically there was very little difference between the two, if any. The Spyder, it was more brightness, I think. It just was a little, tiny little bit brighter than that, but we could dial that out quite successfully. And it was so small, and I was really nitpicking that actually either are going to calibrate your screen successfully, because that is what they're designed to do. And they're all working from the same amount of patches as well. To say the Datacolour and the Spyder was a little bit quicker, so that could be a factor in buying as well. You haven't got to hold it on the screen as much. But there is a little trick where you can kind of angle the screen and kind of rest it on there as well. Now, either will be absolutely fine and do a fantastic job for you. I would be happy with either, to be honest. It's a hard one. I think I'm not really drawn towards one or the other, to be completely honest. Both of them calibrate your screens and do a fantastic job. I quite like the white of the Datacolour, possibly, but I quite like the software of the Calibrite as well. It seems to be quite nice and simple, and it feels like there's a bit more graphical kind of things going on in there. It makes no difference to the calibration whatsoever, but it really, in my opinion, comes down to if you like a white one or the black and grey one. Really, it's as simple as that. They both do amazing calibrations. You'll be happy with either. The Datacolour is a little bit more cost effective at the time of making this video. However, yeah, they're both really equal. I can't really kind of pick between them. So I hope that's been useful and it's shown you how to use the software. And actually, in my opinion, that the screen calibrations are very similar, to be honest, from both manufacturers, as they should be, to be honest, because if I was seeing a big difference with one or the other, then they wouldn't be working from the same set of patches set out by the ICC. So they should be very close and do the same job. Really, it comes down to which software you prefer and, like I said, which colour you prefer, to be honest, and also budget as well, because there are different levels of these screen calibrators that can do projectors, and you've got the advanced settings on them as well, so you can really dive in and really fine-tune your colour output. But for most people, I think 90-95% of the time, the basic function that they do, the easy setup, in some cases they call it, will be absolutely fine. You will have no problems at all. It's what I use 90% of the time. I very, very rarely, I can probably count on one hand how many times I've gone into the advanced features of these devices. So we just need to do a quick screen calibration and off we go. Now, we should redo our calibration probably once every few months, once every other month. You can do it once a month. That seems to be what the manufacturers recommend. But I would say these screens now, new screens on these computers, drift very, very little. So it is worth just doing it probably once every other month, just to bring things back in line. Okay, so I think we've kind of covered screen calibration now. So please don't forget to subscribe to the video. And also, don't forget that we have new videos coming out every Thursday on the Fotospeed YouTube channel. So I will see you next Thursday. Bye-bye.